Welcome to Must See Movies Action Edition. I'm Rebecca LeBlanc, and our first review is for the movie Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. Let's first watch the trailer.
Comm check. We're live.
Target acquired.
What the hell is that?
Abort.
Ethan, what happened in the Kremlin?
It was a setup.
The Russians are classifying this as an undeclared act of war. The blame points to you and your team. The president has initiated Ghost Protocol. The entire IMF has been disavowed.
So what happens now?
Your mission, should you choose to accept it.
Secretary is dead. The four of us are all that remains of the IMF. No safe house, no support or extraction. Everyone connected with this man is an asset with valuable information. We come back with our target, or we don't come back.
And how do you propose that we do that?
We take him out.
Yeah, we take him out, but, you know, discreetly.
Discreetly.
This operation's over before it even begins.
Would you care to explain yourself, Brandt?
Who are you, really?
We all have our secrets. Don't we, Ethan?
Okay, this is a slight wrinkle. We're gonna have to go into the server room from the outside.
We?
I'm on the computer.
Reviewing our first film with me today is Peter Skarzinski from LaSalle College. So Peter, what did you think of the film?
So overall for an action film, I thought that it kind of covered like all the aspects that I would like to see in an action film. So like, you know, you have the shooting scenes, you have the plot, like the setup mm-hmm. of the action, and you have a little bit of romance. You know, a lot of action has a lot of little romance in there, and it also has that a bit. Mm-hmm. So I really liked it, yeah.
And so who's the main character, and what is something that he really struggles with this whole film?
So Tom Cruise is obviously the main character, mm-hmm. as he is in all of the movies. And the thing that he really struggles with in this one is that the situation that they're put in is that an act of terrorism happened, and they were there when it happened, so the blame was put on them. So they now have to be split up, and the group is split up, and they can't do any more missions or whatnot, but the thing is that they have to do a mission that the government doesn't know about. So the whole thing is that they're supposed to be undercover the whole time, and it kind of just adds an extra layer to an already like really big task that they have to do. Mm-hmm.
Definitely more suspense to the story, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And so you mentioned that there are other movies in the Mission Impossible series.
Mm-hmm.
So how many other movies, I guess, is there, and where does this one lie in that?
So there are like 6 films in the series, and I believe that this is the 4th one. None of them really have like plots that really go with each other. They're kind of individual stories. So this one doesn't really fit anywhere in it. It's just another good Mission Impossible movie, mm-hmm. I feel. So yeah.
Is this one of your favorite from the series?
Yeah, I would say that this is my favorite overall because of all of the aspects that it has. And like, it's not too much action because, I don't know, I feel like you can have extremes in anything,
mm-hmm.
so I don't want too much action because then it just kind of gets monotonous and it's just kind of the same thing over and over.
Definitely, so. Definitely. And so what would you say to a friend to recommend them to this movie?
Well, I would first ask if they like shooting scenes because there is a lot of them and there's mm-hmm. a lot of action in it, a lot of explosion, but overall, I would say that if you like action, that this is probably a good movie to start off with, like, and watch if you're really into action as well. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
And so what did you rate this film?
I rated the film an 8 overall, because it wasn't, like I said, it's another Mission Impossible movie. They're mm-hmm. kind of pretty similar.
There's enough of them.
Yeah, they're pretty similar, mm-hmm. but I thought that this was a good one, so I gave it an 8.
Okay, well, thank you so much for co-hosting this segment with me. I enjoyed your company, and we will be back with more must-see reviews right after this commercial break. Don't go away. Do you want to make a positive change in your community? Do Something is an organization that motivates young people to help their community and provides scholarships for outstanding achievement. It provides a range of platforms and services that encourage social activism and give people a way to voice their opinions as individuals. From a service that delivers a bag of daily essentials to local homeless shelters, to platforms for voices to be heard and to join a social activist movement of your choice, Do Something is a leading promoter of social change. So to get involved in your community, please call 212-254-2390, email help@dosomething.org, or visit our website. Let's get together and do something. Founded in 1893, Cotting School started as a place for kids with special needs who require an alternative way of learning. Now over 125 years old, we are known as the premier school for children ages 3 to 22 with moderate to severe disabilities. Therapies are integrated into classroom instructions to ensure your child is receiving the best hands-on care. Groundbreaking programs from devices for communication to our very own sports teams, no school can compete. Please do not hesitate to contact us, and we'd be happy to show you around and stop by and check out one of our many events. If you'd like to have the best possible education for your child, look no further than Cotting. Or you can ask about our many alumni in the Boston area. Once a Falcon, always a Falcon. On 47 West Street in Boston, Bridge Over Troubled Waters has spent nearly 50 years helping homeless youth. This organization was founded in the late 1960s by the Sisters of St. Joseph. This organization is dedicated to transforming the lives of youth through promoting safe, supportive, and encouraging relationships. Clinical counselors are trained and experienced in working with troubled youth, using methods that help with trauma and promote positive youth development. The education and career development staff helps youth get alternative high school degrees on their time. You can reach BOTW's 24-hour runaway hotline by calling 1-800-RUNAWAY or call 617-423-9575 for more information. You can also learn more or make a donation by visiting their website at www.bridgeotw.org. Welcome back to Must See Movies Action Drama Edition. I'm Rebecca LeBlanc, and our second review is for the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. Let's take a look at the trailer. Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Escape from reality.
I enjoyed the show.
I also
write songs.
Our lead singer just quit.
Then you'll need someone new.
I love the way you move on stage. The whole room belongs to you. Don't you see what you could be?
No one will play us on the radio.
We need to get experimental.
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Do it again.
One more.
How many more Galileos do you want?
Roger, there's only room in this band for one hysterical queen.
Mark these words. No one will play a queen.
Fortune favors the bold.
Freddie, concerning your private life.
What more do you need to know? I make music.
I want to give the audience a song that they can perform.
What's the lyric?
Sing it, we will rock you. On.
Ready, Freddie?
Let's do it.
To slow down, Fred.
I just need a bit of time.
What if I don't have time?
We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions.
You're a legend, Fred.
We're all legends.
My second review is for the movie Bohemian Rhapsody, and my guest is Zach Herring from LaSalle College. So what are your thoughts on this movie?
I just think it was an amazing movie. I saw it with my mom. She kind of got me stoked to watch it. We read the book about Freddie Mercury before, and just an incredible portrayal of a man who, you know, lived just a crazy life.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For sure. And the main character, I believe, is played by Rami Malek. And how do you think he did playing Freddie Mercury?
I think he did amazing. Like, just from what I've watched, like videos of Freddie Mercury, reading about him, like his mannerisms, the way he talked, the way he acted. I thought he did an incredible job, and it really just made me buy into the movie even that, you know, much more. Mm-hmm. So that's what I loved about it.
Definitely a tough role to fill.
Yeah.
But that's great that he did such a good job with it. So what is a struggle, I guess, that Freddie Mercury deals with in this movie?
Yeah, well, I mean, the obvious struggle, I mean, was dealing with his homosexuality. He was married to a woman before. But you kind of got the buildup that he was interested, you know, in men, or he had, you know, some, you know, thoughts about it, but he really loved his wife at the same time. So I think it was very contradictory, and it really, you know, messed with him. But, and then, you know, with the whole band, they broke up and, got back together and, you know, kind of killed it at, you know, Live Aid. So it is just an up and down roller coaster. So if you do watch it, just be ready. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's just, there's a lot of issues, but it's, you know, all ends up for the good.
Mm-hmm. And what's a moment from the film that you kind of watched and you took something away from, like a scene or one of your favorite parts?
Yeah, so it was after he walked away from the band. I mean, I'm not trying to give away everything, but he came back to Live Aid to perform, you know, which is a big fundraiser thing they did. And he kind of just got back with the band, brought them back together, and just gave, like, you know, such a memorable performance that just blew everyone away, and it just kind of brought you to, like, just a lot of passion.
Mm-hmm. Definitely powerful. So here are our final scores on the second film under review today. Thank you, Zach, so much for stopping by and reviewing the film. And stay right here. We've got one more review that you don't want to miss right after this short break. Each year, over 7.5 million animals enter shelters nationwide, hoping for a forever home. Sadly, 1.5 million sheltered animals end up euthanized. Animals just like this suffer from neglect or abuse before reaching the safety of the shelter. It's terrible to imagine a pet being mistreated or homeless, but that's the reality of life for millions of animals. It is the mission of the ASPCA to put a stop to animal cruelty. We want to end their suffering, but we need your help to do it. When you visit our website and join our mission to put a stop to animal cruelty, you will receive a free ASPCA calendar. With your help, we can protect animals from needless suffering. When you join our cause, you are helping by providing food and shelter to the animals that have been mistreated. Be their voice and say no to animal cruelty today. The Franklin Park Coalition is a nonprofit organization attempting to keep Franklin Park beautiful. We are trying to involve the community to work, play, and engage in our many activities, such as the Turkey Trot, the largest Thanksgiving Day race in Boston. All ages and all paces are welcome to join. We have a goal to help raise $5,000 in order to support the restoration work performed by Franklin Park Coalition year-round. Volunteer today at franklinparkcoalition.org and help us keep the park strong, vibrant, and clean. Large and small groups are welcome to help us work on the park. Any and all help with conservation work is appreciated. Donations can be made on our website. Stay in touch with us on Twitter and Instagram. We dedicate our time to help protect the beauty of Franklin Park, and we need your help too. Every tree counts. Have you ever wondered where your next meal was coming from? Needed a suit for an interview but couldn't afford it? The Needham Communities Council's mission supports people in Needham who have undermet health, educational, or social needs. They go above and beyond to provide food donations, transportation, tutoring, and more. By donating canned vegetables, spaghetti, peanut butter, and any other non-perishable items, you could help feed a hungry neighbor. Looking to get rid of unwanted clothes? The NCC will gladly take them off your hands. With the help of the NCC's thrift shop, family are able to add to their wardrobes. These are only a couple of the services provided by the Needham community to the NCC. From events to volunteer opportunities, there's plenty of ways to get involved. With help from the community, the NCC is able to serve over 200 Needham households a month. If you're looking to donate or lend a hand, visit www.needhamcommunitycouncil.org. You're watching Must See Movies Action Edition. I'm Rebecca LeBlanc, and our third review is for the movie John Wick. Let's first watch the trailer.
I'm up.
You like that, huh?
Nice ride.
Thanks.
How much?
Excuse me?
How much for the car?
She's not for sale.
You have good day, sir.
Daisy.
I lost everything. That dog was a final gift from my dying wife.
Jonathan. You got out once. You dip so much as a pinky back into this pond, you may find something reaching out to pull you back in.
It's personal.
Where'd you get that car?
What does it matter?
It's not what you did, son. It's who you did it to.
Nobody?
That nobody. It's John Wick.
You working again?
No, just sorting some stuff out.
Task your crew.
How many?
As many as you have.
Hey, John. I thought I'd let myself in.
People keep asking if I'm back. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.
I'm not afraid of John Wick.
Uh-huh. How good's your laundry?
No one's that good.
I thought not.
Reviewing our third film with me is Jared Gerlao from LaSalle College. So Jared, tell us some of your thoughts on this movie.
So John Wick is probably the best action movie I've seen in the past
8 years, it's got everything you could possibly want in an action movie. It's got good, nonstop violence, a great story, compelling characters, everything that I look for in a quality movie.
Mm-hmm. And so what is the plot of John Wick?
So John Wick follows this man, John Wick, as he just lives his normal life without his wife. He just lost his wife through, from cancer. Mm-hmm. And men attack his house in the middle of the night and take his car and kill his dog. And so from then on, John Wick goes on a rampage trying to get revenge and get his car back.
Mm-hmm. For sure. Definitely a good way to get revenge, or a good reason for revenge, I should say. So how is the action scenes play out? Like, how's the choreography?
So the choreography is kind of what John Wick is known for. It's fantastic. The fighting style is just very unique to the movie. When you think of like a movie with great gunplay and fighting and wrestling, John Wick takes the cake. It's got everything you could possibly want in it.
Mm-hmm. You must put a lot of work into the choreography of these scenes. So what is the main character? What's his actual name in real life?
Keanu Reeves. So he's the actor for John Wick. And mm-hmm. if you go online, you can look at like the videos that or the training that he went through to kind of take on this character and make it seem believable. It's really impressive, to say the least, how much time he put into the role.
Mm-hmm. And what's a scene that really sticks out to you, like a favorite scene of yours?
To me, there is a scene, I believe they show it in the trailer. He breaks like this stone floor in his basement, and like it's revealed that he has like a bunch of guns, and I think he has like his old like suit and everything, his old equipment basically. And it's just to symbolize that whenever he buries his equipment, he's done with his work for like however long until he needs it again. And mm-hmm. when he's breaking out his old equipment, you can tell that he means business. And like he
shows his character.
Yeah, he's finally back for more.
So here are our final scores on the last film of our broadcast. And Jared, thank you so much. I appreciate your help with today's show, and I hope you can join me again sometime. And thank you for seeing Must See Movies, and I hope you enjoyed the show, and we'll see you next time. The Trevor Project is the leading national organization providing crisis intervention and suicide prevention service to the LGBTQ youth. With suicide rates in the LGBTQ youth on the rise, it is important to provide them with the resources to turn to in a time of need. The Trevor Project provides a 24/7 text and call line where LGBTQ youth can get in touch with a trained counselor who is available to talk and guide them for no charge. The main goals of the Trevor Project are to provide crisis service, life-affirming resources, LGBTQ education and support, to ensure a safer future for LGBTQ youth. If you or someone you love is currently struggling, please reach out. To help, go to the Trevor Project's website in order to learn how you can become a volunteer or donate at this website below. With your help, we can grow to build a safer world for the members of the LGBTQ community. Every child, no matter the shape or size, color or hair, whether they are rich or poor, deserves their needs met. Baby Basics, Inc. is a nonprofit, 100% volunteer organization that provides and distributes diapers. We believe by providing these babies with hygiene essentials that we will then be able to maximize their potential development. Founded in 1997, we have been able to provide families with over 2 million diapers to thousands of babies. With our sponsors and partners such as WIC and the Congregational Church of Needham, we can distribute, store, and receive referrals in communities throughout South Boston, Dedham, and Needham. At Baby Basics, our goal is to provide as many families as possible with diapers and kindness across the country. Visit the website on the screen or call us at 617-305-3899 if you would like to donate or volunteer. Oh, hi. Did you know the YWCA is proud to serve over 2 million Americans in over 200 cities in the U.S. and over 25 million individuals worldwide? Our mission is to eliminate racism, empower women, and to promote peace, justice, freedom, and dignity for all. Our services vary by location, but we use everything at our disposal to meet the needs of our communities. The YWCA is the largest provider of domestic violence services in the U.S., providing services like emergency shelters to crisis hotlines. We also provide women's health and wellness programs that are open to the community. Since the 1800s, the YWCA has provided support for minorities and aided in racial justice. We seek to help women and their families in any way possible, whether it be protecting a victim of domestic abuse, providing a safe place, or just giving your kids a place to stay after school. The YWCA, empowering women, eliminating racism.